Hello guys, welcome back. So today I'm going to be doing Ethereum versus USD because many people ask me to do Ethereum versus USD instead of Bitcoin. The reason I was doing Bitcoin is because I only buy altcoins using Bitcoin. So to me, the price with USD is irrelevant. But because most people wants to see this in USD, then I'm going to start doing it in USD now. Since I don't buy ETH anymore, I guess I don't mind doing it in USD now. So we start with the weekly candles. This is Ethereum versus USD, 1 week candles from Coinbase. And all that I can see here is that we went up parabolic, then we had a big crash, and then we bounced at this point here. So we created a new low. So all I can do with this information is draw an ascending support from where the parabolic movement started here and going to this new low that was just created. Now, to find out if we are still uptrending and not downtrending, because of course we come from a long downtrend here, but since we bounce here, now we can draw this line and we can test this line. If this line holds the price here, it means we're still uptrending. But if when the price touches this line, if this line cannot hold the price, I expect to have a big sell-off here, because that's how bear markets react. Every time an ascending support is broken, we experience a big sell-off because people realizes that this line doesn't hold, so they sell, and we're gonna have a big sell-off if this line doesn't hold. But we're still days or weeks away from testing this line, so all I can do here is just wait for this line to be tested. Now, going to the daily candles, exact same situation. So we were uptrending in this green channel here. Then we went up parabolic, then went down, it bounced at the top of the channel. This would be a bull trap. And then this is where everybody thought we were going to be going all-time highs again, but it doesn't happen in bear markets. Most likely, this looks like a bubble popped. So we went down, and so we still had this top of the channel here acting as a support. And if you see, this is referring what I was saying just now 1 minute ago about breaking ascending supports. When we are in bear markets, every time an ascending support is broken, what do we get? Boom, huge sell-off, because people understand this ascending support, it's not holding. Therefore, we're in a bear market and they sell, which causes the price to go down very heavily. So that's what happened here. But the bottom of this channel actually held the price here. We had a bounce. And then eventually it was broken, but not for so long, and it went right back up inside this channel. And right now the price is going completely sideways, so this is not giving me a lot of information. I guess it's gonna be holding inside this channel, on the bottom of this channel, but I think it's gonna be going sideways for days, maybe weeks. So all I have here is this ascending support line here. If the price actually goes down and test this line, if this line doesn't hold, you can expect a huge sell-off here. But so far we're inside this channel, so it looks it's gonna continue to go sideways. I mean, so long as the price continues to go sideways, there's not much more analysis I can do here. At least we broke this descending channel that we were in before, so I expect to go sideways for a little bit. And now if we go to the 4 hours candles, for the people that likes to do day trading or swing trading, this is a no trading zone to me, because my number one rule for trading is you only trade uptrends. You don't trade downtrends or sideways. So right now we're going sideways and we don't know when this is gonna finish. So far it looks it's gonna continue to go sideways, so there's not much I can say here. It's not telling me much, this chart. So sorry guys, we're gonna have to continue to wait until we have to actually test this bottom of the channel line or this other ascending resistance. We're not in it doesn't look like it's going to do any crazy movement here. Of course, I could be wrong, and you can expect anything crazy with crypto, just like we've seen with Bitcoin. Out of nowhere, it just went up to all-time highs. I guess it could happen also with Ethereum. But yeah, there's no way I can predict that. Okay, guys, so I could be wrong in everything I say, so just remember, trade at your own risk. Thank you very much for watching. Please give me some feedback, and I'll see you soon in the next video. Bye.